What's good, Wealth Builders? It's your boy Devon back again with another video. You are now riding with the Wealth Builder as we ride through my neighborhood, chilling, talking about certain topics, things like that, that pertain to life and online marketing. You know what I mean? All right, so today's topic, what I want to touch on is basically this, man. I know you know about the title. Basically, you know, online marketing in hard times, how to deal with them, you know what I'm saying, in your business, when you're having hard times in your online marketing business. Meaning, and what I mean by hard times, let me clarify this. Hard times means, you know, you're not getting any sign-ups, or if you get a sign-up, you get a sign-up here and there, or you're not getting many sales, or things like that. Basically, you're not profitable yet in your business. All right, so I'm not gonna give you with no generic keep on going, you just gotta keep on keeping. But that's kind of part of it, though, to be quite honest with you. That is part of the process. You have to keep on going, but what you need to do in that keep on going mentality, you need to know where you're going, right? So what I mean by that is you have to pay attention to your analytics, okay? All right, you know, if you're a YouTube marketer, you know that. You know, you have to pay attention to your analytics. And what I mean by pay attention to your analytics is basically this, all right? Every week or every day or what have you, you need to take a look at your progression, okay? You wanna say, okay, how many clicks I got today? Did I get any clicks on my website today? Okay, how many? Was it 5 or 10 or 200 or, you know, what have you, okay? That's number one. You gotta know your analytics, all right? Did you get any opt-ins, okay? Did you get any leads? Anybody, you know, kind of sort of interested, they might not have signed up, they didn't pay their money or they didn't purchase anything, but they opted in. So you basically got someone, you got another person to promote to. Basically, that's what that is. If you get an opt-in lead and they don't buy anything, or even if they buy something, you have another person to directly promote to in their email box, okay? So they're highly or more likely interested in what you're selling or your business opportunity or what have you, okay? So you got to take a look at that. Also, then once you start taking a look at the analytics, now you got to start paying attention to what you're doing, okay? Are you, you know, did you make any Facebook posts this today or this week? How many Facebook posts did you post that were for your business, okay? How many people did you talk to, okay? Did you talk to anybody? Did you email your list? Did you shoot a YouTube video? And how many YouTube videos did you put up? Okay. What else analytics you got to pay attention to? It's quite a few different analytics you got to pay attention to. Okay. What's the response to your FB ads if you're doing paid traffic? Okay. If you're doing paid solo ads, how many opt-ins did you get from your paid solo ad? Okay, is your opt-in page converting? Okay, you got to look at that too. Like, are you getting, do you need to upgrade your opt-in page? Maybe you need to upgrade your opt-in page and get a better conversion. Okay, some people want to look at, you know, the conversion rate usually has to be between, I say, 20 to 30% of your clicks on your opt-in page for the most part. Okay, so 30% of your clicks should be opt-ins. Not sales, but opt-ins. Okay, and then your sales are usually anywhere between 1% to 5%. Okay, the low is usually the benchmark, because most marketers aren't that great yet. Okay, and they don't practice enough on their email marketing. So it's usually 1% to 2% sales. Okay, within the first 10 to 15 days of person being on your list. this is the analytics you have to pay attention to. You got to pay attention to this stuff to know where your business is, okay? And if you're not getting sales or you're not getting signups or things like that, then you say to yourself, okay, well, what am I doing wrong, or what am I not doing, okay? That's the better question. What am I not doing, okay? Am I spending my lunch time at work posting on Facebook about my business, or am I spending my lunch time at work BSing and scrolling up and down Facebook and not doing any business, okay? Am I spending my lunch time at work frivolously, not shooting a video in my car? Am I not shooting any videos on the weekend? Maybe I need to go home late at night and shoot a video or promote on Facebook, do more posts on Instagram. Okay, maybe I need to invest. If I don't have the time to do all this stuff, maybe I should invest in buying some traffic or buying some Facebook ads or something to that effect. That's so I can be more successful. Okay, that's so I can make more sales in a more efficient way. Okay, this is the stuff you have to know. Okay, to know if your business is being successful or you just messing around and it's not really a business to you, okay? And you just, you know, you saw somebody with some good results and you joined them, or you thought e-commerce was a great opportunity, so you went ahead and jumped on board, but you don't really know what you're doing, or you don't know the analytics about behind things, or behind why you haven't had success, or the analytics of why you haven't been able to get any signups or things like that. You got to pay attention to this stuff to know if you are actually having hard times in your business, or you just haven't been doing your job. You just haven't been promoting well enough. Okay? So don't quit because you haven't had success. First, learn why you haven't had success. Okay, because success doesn't come to those that just post a Facebook post every so often. Success doesn't come to those who just drop a YouTube video every now and again. Success doesn't come to those people that promote on Instagram 2 times a week and call it a day. No, that doesn't happen, okay? Success doesn't happen for those people. Okay, success happens for people that put in work, that be like, listen, I'm going to drop a video today. And then I'm gonna drop a video next week. And then I'm gonna drop a video every week, or 2 times a week, 3 times a week, okay? You have to know that you left everything on the table, okay? What I mean by leaving everything on the table is that you know that you tried everything you could do, okay? You worked on your lunch break, you worked at night, You worked on the weekends, you promote on the weekends, you drop videos on the Friday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. You know what I'm saying? Like, you put in work, okay? I can't tell you what you should do for your business model, but all I know is if you feel like you've done everything in your possibility, everything you've tried everything, and it still hasn't panned out for you, then maybe you need to quit at that point. Okay, maybe it's just not for you. Or maybe you just need to change your vehicle of becoming financially free. Maybe you need to do something else that you are more interested in, okay? Like I said, you have to feel like you put everything on the table. Not feel like, know that you put everything on the table, okay? Everything that you put out or post on Facebook or post on Instagram or post on Twitter or YouTube, okay, you should be like, okay, well, it should be a everyday thing. You should be promoting your business every day, or promoting your company, promoting whatever you're doing, affiliate marketing, whatever it is, your blog, whatever it is. Just go ahead and promote, man. Every day. You gotta give it like 90 days, you know what I'm saying? Before you can be like, yo, listen, I did everything I can do. Okay? Once you do that, once you give it about 90 days and be like, I did everything I could do, every day and really was real with yourself, then I would say quit. Okay? Hang it up. It's probably not for you. You know? But in 90 days, if you don't have any type of, like, you know what I'm saying, spark, like opt-ins and clicks and constant people, you know, at least some constant flow of leads, and you just haven't converted them yet. If you haven't been able to do that within 90 days, you know what I'm saying, at least the leads part, then yeah, it's not for you. But if you've been able to gather leads and gather people that are interested in your business, at least 100 to 200 people within 90 days off of free traffic, then you know, you can build from there. You can go from there. You can bring your business to the level that you're looking to bring it to. What the fuck? Niggas be trying to kill themselves. Anyhow, man. Somebody did just some wildness on the road. Anyway, yeah, so thanks for subscribing to the channel. Being a loyal subscriber, I do appreciate you, Wealth Builders. I got some things coming for you guys for the channel. Okay, I'm gonna add some more content specific to new businesses and building businesses, and you know, investments, I should say, in building your investment portfolio, things you can invest in that's not just stocks and bonds. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about real legit companies that you can invest in and start, you know, building a solid income. Okay? Solid investment portfolio, I should say. And then I'm gonna also teach you how to join with us in my econ. Okay, if you haven't heard about my econ is a financial services company that help you change your personal financial situation as you become more successful and build a, you know, better you as far as your personal finances are concerned, and build a business either online or offline is up to you. So yeah, more videos about my econ, more videos about the Conversion Pros, the system I use to market with. Okay, probably gonna get into some more self-development videos, and you know, because I think self-development and mindset is a big part of building a business, you know what I'm saying, no matter offline or online. But definitely, you know what I'm saying, more videos like that, a little bit more insight into my life, my personal life on this channel. So yeah, man, I'm gonna take the Wealth Builders to a whole new level, you know what I'm saying, soon. So yeah, we're just gonna drip feed it though. We ain't dropping everything at once, you know what I'm saying? That would be asinine. Anyhow, again, thanks for subscribing to the channel. Do remember, Wealth Builders, make more, what? Save more than do what? Build more. Peace.
It's the Wealth Builders, baby.